Hey guys, it's Yaya and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be focusing on some major key ingredients used to help protect us from the sun, heal us after we come out of the sun, and ultimately give us a beautiful summer glow for even smooth skin, okay? In partnership with Oslove Organics, I want to first introduce you to some star ingredients for this glow body butter, okay? We're going to start off with shea butter. Shea butter is known for its healing and soothing properties to protect and heal the skin. It can also help reduce the appearance of scars and blemishes for a more clear complexion or look over time. One of my favorite butters, Murumuru butter, also has protective properties from the sun. But what I love about it is that it kind of mimics a synthetic silicone in creating this breathable barrier that protects your skin from water loss. And the butter we all know and love, cocoa butter, has been used for years to help smooth out scars, blemishes, dark spots, and any other damage that could have come from the sun. Each of these butters are jam-packed with antioxidants known to reduce the appearance of sun damage. Moving on to our liquid oils, we have Abyssinian oil and cranberry seed oil. Abyssinian oil has restorative properties and it's also a very absorbent oil, leaving a non-greasy feel, and is ideal for most products. Cranberry seed oil has a high amount of catechins, which basically fights the signs of aging. And its extract also has promising antimicrobial properties, which means it could possibly be used as a very mild co-preservative. Vitamin E is a very well-known antioxidant, and it's definitely going to help protect your product from oxidizing or going rancid super fast, especially your products that have a very high oil content. It's definitely great for skin and UV protection. Alright, so let's go ahead and jump into this formulation. I'm starting off with carrot seed oil. This is going to be used to complement this body butter. Carrot oil has a very high SPF rate, which is about between 38 to 40, which means it can definitely help block out the sun basically and protect your skin. To the carrot oil, we're going to be adding our Abyssinian oil and our cranberry seed oil. Each oil has a clear to pale yellowish appearance. Alright, so now we're ready to combine our butters and our liquid oils together for the base of this butter. I'm going to start by melting down my cocoa butter just because it's one of the harder butters and it takes a little longer for it to melt down. I want to basically try to preserve the integrity of all the ingredients as much as I can. So once the cocoa butter has been melted down, I will then add the Murumuru butter, which is slightly harder than the shea butter, which is the softest butter, okay? Then after it melts down just slightly, I'm gonna go ahead and add in my liquid oils. Now that the oils have been melted down, I'm gonna go ahead and place it into a bowl so that I can place it in the freezer for it to slightly solidify so I can whip it up later on, as with all body butters, okay? Now, the only thing that I would like to say at this point is that choosing which container that you want to put your butters in while it's cooling down is so important. And I've been trying to master this, but it's been kind of difficult, okay? So using this bowl, it definitely froze unevenly, as you will see in a second. It's kind of hard around the edges and really soft in the middle, so it didn't freeze evenly. It didn't cool down evenly, which I can't stand. The solution is you can remelt it down and try it again, or if it's still pliable, just take a spoon and kind of just scrape it down and mix it up until it becomes like a really thick batter type paste or whatever. Once it's smooth, you can whip it up. I'm just using my immersion blender. It has a whisk attachment to whip up this butter. Now you want to deep bowl, okay? That's gonna really allow you to whip up the butter the best of your ability. So those are some common mistakes that happen when whipping up butter, so try a deeper bowl, and also try to find a flatter bowl that will basically cool down or freeze at a more even consistency, so that when you do whip up your butters or take it out the freezer, it's not super hard and you don't have to worry about remelting your butter, okay? Once you have it the perfect consistency, then you can add your other ingredients. I'm introducing white tea extract. This is an oil soluble extract, so you're definitely not adding any water. There is a water-based white tea extract out there. This is a very, very powerful antioxidant. It's very similar to green tea, but is known to be even more potent than green tea when helping with anti-aging, healing the skin, evening out the skin, and just keeping that youthful look that you want and love. To complement the white tea, I'm adding papaya enzyme. This is also oil soluble, so it's perfect to add to anhydrous formulations like this one that have no water, okay? It's gonna help clear up the skin, any kind of dark spots, irritation, dead skin, is getting rid of it. And that's what's so amazing about fruit enzymes, because they almost enhance the abilities of other ingredients to work. Next ingredient is arrowroot powder. It's very commonly known to help degrease formulations, especially butters, especially shea butter, that can sometimes have a greasy type feel to it. It's going to help the ingredients absorb faster in your skin, giving you this powdery smooth feel to the skin when you apply your butter, instead of just, you know, that oil that kind of sits on there depending on what type of butters you use. You can already see just how beautiful the texture of this whipped butter is. So beautiful, and I definitely believe that it has a lot to do with the choices of oils and butters used in their combinations, their ratio. I use significantly less cocoa butter than shea butter. I feel like if you use more cocoa butter, you would probably have a different outcome than what I have here. So remember, not only are the type of ingredients you use important, it's also important to know the ratio and how are you formulating those products or ingredients to work together. This has to be maybe the best consistency I've ever made as far as body butters go. So as far as formulating go, I think this has been the best so far as texture. Even compared to the mango butter I did previously, this has even more of a silky smooth lotion-y type feel to it. And after a day or two or three, it still had that beautiful, fluffy, silky texture. It did not change at all. So if you're looking for that type of texture, I recommend this over the mango body butter that I did previously. Alright, so next we're just gonna jazz it up a little bit, add our antioxidant, which is gonna protect our butter, which is the vitamin E. We're gonna also add some fragrance just to give it a beautiful, nice scent. I add a combination of, I believe, tea tree, and then I also have this beautiful white tea essential oil to complement the white tea extract, which does not have a smell, and it just smells so beautiful, you guys. It smells so good. You can use any oil combination you like. Geranium is also a beautiful smell. I think I also added just a little bit of tea tree just to complement the already white tea effect. Okay, so just beautiful, fluffy, lovely, and I love it. This by far is my favorite consistency when it comes to body butters. This is just beautiful. So how are we using this body butter? I would suggest as aftercare. When you come out of the sun and other stress or pollutants from outside, you know, you want to put it on your, after cleansing, you want to put it a little bit on your skin. And I think it'll definitely help reverse any damage that was caused by the sun, or basically heal any damage that you might have. You can also take preventative measures and basically use it while you're in the sun, before you go out in the sun, but I would not recommend using it as a sole sunscreen. I definitely feel like you need something for extra protection when it comes to that, okay? So if you have dark spots, age spots, hyperpigmentation, these are ingredients that you definitely want to utilize and to help improve that. Will you see immediate results? I don't think so, but I believe that the extracts and the enzymes will definitely help to emphasize the abilities of the shea butter, the cocoa butter, and the murumuru butter, the cranberry seed, and all the amazing ingredients that are inside of this body butter. So that's it, you guys. What do you think? Please leave a comment down below. I love hearing from you guys. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. I want to say thank you again to Oslove Organics for sponsoring this video. Please go check them out down below. There'll be some links so you guys can check out the ingredients that we use, and definitely just see more about them. Now I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.